I eventually met Craig O'Brien, O'Brien Graphics, and started working with him. And I learned a lot from Craig. He's a master printer. And I worked with Craig doing monotypes for maybe 10 years. He's excellent with colors, mixes colors and so forth. And he's a good technician. He lets the artist do his or her thing. But if you ask him a question, you get a good answer, and it's a good learning experience as well as creating art. Is an orange. What is that color?
Orange.
Is that a green?
It's blue, dark blue.
Okay, well.
This one here, Lloyd?
Yeah. Let's use this one. Okay, I'm going to try and distribute these colors around, putting a little bit in different places, kind of balancing it, like a little bit over here. Kind of want to get the colors distributed around so that they don't run over each other. They kind of fit together. That green with that one looked pretty nice. See what that does? It breaks it up. Good. Okay, the ink's been put down on the type and engravings, and this is ready to print. And what we're going to do next is print that first one, the plate. We have a piece of paper then with that art on it. Lay it on here, run it through the press, Craig squeezes it down really hard. Let's see what it looks like. That's about it as far as going through because of the stretch. Now you're going to see a ghost image.
Ooh, beautiful.
Isn't that interesting?
Yes.
Now, one of the things you could do is take paint on a plate with a very based out color and overprint this. And the type would be R.
Yeah.
Quiet up there.
Chow time, huh, guys?
Yeah, they're hungry. We gonna get more ink on it?
Yeah.
A double ghost. When we're doing this, you have to do them and then figure out what you got to do to change it. You know, more ink here, less ink, and so forth. You just kind of experiment as you go, because you're never sure what you're going to come up with after it runs through the press. You're always kind of experimenting.
Yep.
And frequently a mistake winds up to be the best piece you've done. See, now look how much better that looks.
Well, I flipped it around.
So yeah. You turned it upside down and now you've got a whole different feel.
Beautiful.
Isn't that interesting?
Yeah.
So we took that form that had the type with the ink and did two runs to get the ghost image, and the first run through, and then Craig turned the paper around and printed the next ghost image upside down, and that's what we got. There's an enormous amount of technique to the printing process that Craig has mastered. Betty and I had brought a old beautiful goose from China in 1980. I did a monotype of this goose.